Hi, this is Sean. In this lesson, I'm going to quickly go over how to drive a gear system with some particles using rigid body dynamics and some constraints. And then another question one of my students had was, what if you wanted to drive a secondary gear system? And a lot of the time, doing it with dynamics is okay, but you probably can get way more efficiencies by using an expression. And so I'm going to go over that. So let's get started. I created just a cube inside of here. So I'm going to just emit particles from that cube. So going into particles, emit from object, and then I'm hitting Alt V. I've got the particles created. I'll select those particles and adjust some of the defaults there. We don't need that many. So under the emitter tab, we'll take that down to like maybe 30 per second, and then let's also add some gravity to them. If we had used an end particle system, we would have just gotten gravity for free. But anyways, now we've got some gravity going on. Now let's set up our gear. So we will select the gear, and we will go to soft rigid bodies. We will make that an active rigid body. So here, then we will need to make those particles collide with the active rigid body. So select the particles, shift select the gear, and go under particles and make collide. And then now the particles are colliding, but they're not driving the gear yet. So we can make them drive the gear by selecting the rigid body that we've created, which is the gear small teeth. And go into the rigid body tab and turn on particle collision. And by default, the particles have a mass of one. And we can take a look at this gear system. It also has a mass of one. So if you wanted to change how fast this gear rotates, one of the things you could probably start with is modifying the mass. But for this example, I'm going to just have the particles. There's a one-to-one ratio. So as you can see right now, if the particles hit it, it just goes flying off. So we need to constrain this to its location. So let's go into our soft rigid bodies. Let's create a hinge constraint. And I'm going to hit the 4 key. We want the hinge, right now the hinge is facing 90 degrees from where we want it to. So I'm just going to rotate that 90 degrees. So back to shaded mode. Now we should see it's sort of moving the way we want it to. Great. Okay, so now let's talk about having this gear drive this gear. And this is where, just a little bit of knowledge about gearing ratios can help out. So I may put some numbers down here. This gear has 12, 12 teeth. And then this gear has 48 teeth. And so then that immediately creates a gear ratio of 1 to 4. So, and then also you sort of have to understand, which it's pretty easy to notice, once this starts rotating, you'll see that this is rotating on a different axis, and it's also rotating in the opposite direction. So let's hook this up. So the way we're going to hook it up first is using an expression. So to do that, you can go in and look at the, select, here's the gear. And then you can go into the expression editor. And so let's just go here and select the rotation and then go to expressions. Let me just drag this over. And so we've got the rotation X right now that we want to drive down the X-axis. And so let's just copy this, close it, and now we'll use on the gear big teeth, we'll do the same thing. Select these rotation parameters, go into expressions. I'm just going to paste that, the gear small dot rotation x. And instead, we got the gear big teeth rotation x. But really, that's not what we're looking for. You can sort of see this here. It's actually the rotation z. So I'll just copy the rotation x, paste it, and then fix it. I'll say the rotation Z is really what we want. and equals the gear small rotation x. And so now, if I played this, it would work, but it wouldn't work correctly. So let's just show this off. So I'm hitting Alt V again. So you can see it's going in the wrong direction and it's not moving at the right speed. Okay, so what do we need to do to fix this and make sure it goes at the right speed and in the right direction? So let's go back in and go to our expression editor here. There we are. And so really what we need to do is we need to reverse the direction. And since this is at a gearing ratio it's easily known, right? 12 into 48 is 4 times. And so this needs to spin, this is going to drive this at the inverse of 4 times, which is 25%. So let's just say 0.25 times. And then it also needs to go in the opposite direction. So really it's minus 0.25. There we go. And let's hit edit and close. Now let's check out how that's working. Hey, check that out. All right, so now it looks pretty good. And let's just show how we can do this in another using the node editor. Sometimes nodes are a little bit more efficient than expressions, so that's why you might want to consider doing that. So first we got to take the expression off here. And let's just delete that and go into our node editor. I'm going to once again clear here. I've selected the two gears and I just want to select the transform nodes. So this is the transform node for the gear with small teeth, and here's the transform node for the gear with large teeth. And what we want is we want to multiply times 0.25. When the small gear rotates, we'll multiply times minus 0.25. So we need a multiply divide node. So I just hit tab, type multiply divide, and we'll type minus 0.25 in the x. And we really only need one input since we're going to just do times the x, and then we're going to drive the z on the gear with big teeth. Let's just confirm that. And so now let's go back in here. I'm going to hit the 4 key. Actually, we only need to hit the 3 key. We don't need to show so many connections since we're just using the rotation. So I'm going to open up the rotation there. We'll do the same thing, hit the 3 key. And really, we want the rotation of the X to come out. We'll plug that in. And let's just double check. We want that into input 2. So input 2x. So now, and input 2x will be multiplied by minus 0.25. And now we'll take this and we'll take the output of x into the rotation of z. And now that should be the exact same result as what we had with our expression. So let me just rewind and hit play. Excellent. So, and we can do the same thing with other gears in the system. So that pretty much wraps it up for now. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you in the next video.